Good morning everyone. Today we'll begin our session with types of beams. So there are normally five types of beams that we mention. The first one being simply supported beam. Simply supported beam, we have already learned about simply supported, supports. So here we have simply supported beam, which is supported at both the ends, or we can represent it like this: there are two reactions on both the ends and given, or it is separated by a distance of L. That is a simply supported beam. Like anything, maybe a bench or a table, we can say it is supported at both the ends, so it is a simply supported beam. Next one is cantilever beam. Cantilever beam is which is having fixed support at one end and the other end is free. Fixed at one end and other end is free. You can give the example of sunshade in a house. Sunshade, as you know, in a building, the sunshade one side will be fixed and the other side will be hanging freely. That is an example for cantilever beam. That is, there is no support for the other end. Third type is fixed beam. Fixed beam is which is supported at both the ends, which is permanently supported. That is, there is no possible of any kind of movement in such a beam. Like normally in building structures, what you have at the top and all are actually fixed beams. Next we have continuous beams. Continuous beams means there are more than two supports. Not just at the ends it is being supported, it is supported by more than two supports. Here, as you can see the figure, there are three supports here. Maybe different kinds of support. It can be simply support, it can be roller support, or any kind of support which may be supporting. This normally you can see in a go down and all, where you have so many supports given to the beam. And fifth one is overhanging beam. Overhanging beam means, suppose the beam is there and it is being supported in between, and the other end x distance, which is giving the x distance, L is being supported and x distance is hanging freely. That is called an overhanging beam. Or else this type we can have overhanging beam. That is, see, in between two supports are there, AB of length L, and BD is a length Y and AC is a length X. Both are hanging freely on both sides. That is, there is no support on both the ends. So these are the five types of beams you should be knowing. There is one more type which is not very important, but you should know it. That is a propped cantilever beam. Propped cantilever beam is a beam which is supported or fixed at one end and other end it is supported by a simple support or a roller. Okay, so this type of is called as propped cantilever beam. These are the types of beams we have to study. Now next topic is on all these beams. We know that beam is a horizontal structure, and all these beams, there'll be loads which is acting on these beams. So while talking about the loads that is acting on the beams, we have three types of loads that we should talk about. First one is the point load or the concentrated load. Okay, this is the normal ones we are dealing with: point load or concentrated load, which is concentrated at one particular point. That is, you can see here 10 newton, 5 newton and again 10 newton. 10 newton is concentrated at A, 5 is concentrated at B and 10 is concentrated at C. This is a simply supported beam. Whatever may be the beam, loadings that is acting at a single point or concentrated at one point is called as point load or concentrated load. Normally in problems, we have been dealing with point loads. Other two types which you are not familiar with is, first one is uniformly distributed load, or in short we call it UDL. That you can see here, this is a UDL which is actually shown like a string like this, and it is acting over a length. This, suppose it's a beam, simply supported beam, load is there like a string. It is acting over a length L. The value of load is W, any 10, 20, whatever, per meter. Okay. Or another way of representing this UDL is like this. It's a rectangular format and W per meter is a height of this and the length is L. So these are the two ways of representing a UDL. So what is actually UDL? UDL is load uniformly acting throughout a length. throughout a length, it will be having uniform value. That means every point if you take, it has a value W. Here also, every point if you take, it has a value W. Over the length L, it is having the same value. That is uniformly distributed load. An example, you can say, if you have a ground surface, over that I am arranging one layer of bricks. Okay, so bricks each will have same weight, so it will be the same load or force which will be acting on that ground surface throughout that length, how much length we are placing the brick. So the example is brick layer kept uniformly on ground surface, that is UDL. But we are not dealing with such type of load in problems. Obviously we'll have to convert this UDL into point load when we are doing the problems. That we'll see later. Now the third type of load you have is uniformly varying load, or UVL. In short, UVL. It will not have same value like UDL at every point. It will have varying value throughout the length. That is, here at A it is 0 and here at B it's having a value W per meter. So the length is, the value of load is going on increasing when we are having the moving along the length. Here also it's this trapezoidal load is also a UVL. See, here it's having W1 and here it's having W2 value. Over a length, the value is changing. So the load which varies uniformly over a length is called as UVL. An example for UVL is brick layer kept on ground. Supported on top of it is a slope roof. That is, you have a brick layer that we place evenly, or many uniform brick layers we are placing, and over that we are keeping a sloping roof. That is the uniformly distributed load. So, uniformly varying load. So these are the types of loadings you should know. Thank you.